Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome to another episode of our fascinating series towards understanding Surah Yusuf. I am your host, Yasir Qadhi. In our last episode, we had just reached the point where Ya'qub alayhi salam is informed by his sons that Binyamin has stolen. And because of that, Binyamin was prevented from coming back. And Ya'qub finds this incredible to believe. And now he has a very, very moving passage, which will be the subject of today's episode. Stay with us.
لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب ما كان حديثا يفترى ولكن تصديق الذي بين يديه وتفصيل كل شيء وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. In our previous episode, we had reached the point where the sons of Ya'qub alayhi salam confront their father and they tell him, it's not our fault that Binyamin stole. We saw with our own eyes that he stole and that is why we were not able to bring him back. And so out of the 12 sons of Ya'qub alayhi salam, only 9 remain. What was his response and what did he do? This is the topic of today's episode. And as is our usual custom, we begin with a recitation of the Qur'an. And I ask if my viewers can follow along with me. We will recite from verse 83 onwards.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال بل سولت لكم أنفسكم أمرا فصبر جميل عسى الله أن يأتيني بهم جميعا إنه هو العليم الحكيم وتولى عنهم وقال يا أسفى على يوسف وقال يا أسفى على يوسف وابيضت عيناه من الحزن فهو كظيم قالوا تالله تفتأ تذكر يوسف حتى تكون حرضا أو تكون من الهالكين قال إنما أشكو بثي وحزني إلى الله وأعلم من الله ما لا تعلمون يا بني اذهبوا فتحسسوا من يوسف وأخيه ولا تيأسوا من روح الله إنه لا ييأس من روح الله إلا القوم الكافرون فلما دخلوا عليه قالوا يا أيها العزيز مسنا وأهلنا الضر وجئنا ببضاعة مزجاة فأوف لنا الكيل وتصدق علينا إن الله يجزي المتصدقين قال هل علمتم ما فعلتم بيوسف وأخيه إذ أنتم جاهلون قالوا أئنك لأنت يوسف قال أنا يوسف وهذا أخي قد من الله علينا إنه من يتق ويصبر فإن الله لا يضيع أجر المحسنين قالوا تالله لقد آثرك الله علينا وإن كنا لخاطئين قال لا تثريب عليكم اليوم يغفر الله لكم وهو أرحم الراحمين.
So in these series of verses, Ya'qub alayhi salam responds to these accusations and he says,
قَالَ بَلْ سَوَّلَتْ لَكُمْ أَنفُسُكُمْ أَمْرًا.
The exact same phrase that he says when they came to him with the story of Yusuf being eaten by the wolf. He said, something has, your nafs, your souls have made something appear pleasing to you. This is something you have concocted. I know my son. I know Binyamin and he would never steal. I don't care what you are saying. I don't care how many people have seen this. It is not possible for my son Binyamin to be a thief. So he believes this to be yet another plot. They have hatched an even more cunning, an even more evil, an even more conniving plot, such that even the caravan believes that Binyamin has stolen. And subhanAllah, he was not too far from the truth. Binyamin had not stolen, but it wasn't the brothers who hatched the plot. It was the brother of Binyamin. It was Yusuf alayhi salam. So he was right, and yet he was wrong. He was right that Binyamin was innocent, but he was wrong to blame the brother. In this, he was wrong. Rather, it was Yusuf alayhi salam. And he was about to find out very soon what the situation was. But right now, he believes this to be a plot from the brothers. And what can he do? What can he do? فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ. Once again, the exact same phrase that he said when it came to his other son, Yusuf alayhi salam. And the meaning of صَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ can be, as we said, a number of meanings. Of them is, I have no option other than to be patient, a beautiful patient. And of the meanings is, the best option that I have, the best thing that I can do is to be patient. And of the meanings is, and I will be patient, a type of patience that is the best type of patience. And this shows us that patience is of levels. You can have a patience that is acceptable, you can have a patience that is good. He didn't want any of that. He wanted sabrun jameel, which is the best form of patience. And the highest form of patience is that you don't complain to men. You don't seek the sympathy of others. Rather, you accept the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you only pray to Allah and make dua to Allah and complain to Allah. And we talk about what does it mean to complain to Allah. And he still does not lose hope. He has lost three of his children now in the sense that he doesn't know where Yusuf is. He doesn't know when Binyamin will be released from freedom. And as for the oldest one, he has imposed exile upon himself. So he says, عَسَى اللَّهُ أَنْ يَأْتِيَنِي بِهِمْ جَمِيعًا. This is what you call optimism. And optimism is a part of Iman. He says, still I hope, inshaAllah, Allah will bring all of them back to me. You see, my dear brothers and sisters, being optimistic in Allah is a part of Iman. To hope the best from Allah, to expect the best from Allah, to want that Allah Azza wa Jalla will give you everything that you want, to expect this is a sign of Iman. And to always think bad, oh, Allah is not going to respond to my du'as. Oh, Allah is not going to give me what I want. Oh, how can Allah forgive me? This is a very evil thought. In fact, it goes against, it contradicts true iman. The believer always has the best hope in Allah. The believer always expects the best from Allah. And here is Ya'qub having his favorite son taken away and abducted, and his second favorite son now in captivity and slavedom, and his third favorite son imposed exile upon himself in a land far, far away. And yet he says, I still hope all three of them will come back to me. عَسَى اللَّهُ أَنْ يَأْتِنِي بِهِمْ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-alim and al-hakim. The meaning of al-alim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows where everyone is. Allah knows what their situation is. Allah knows why this is happening to me. And He is al-hakim, so He is all-wise. So I put my trust in Allah that whatever is happening for a wisdom.
I know that I don't understand it. I know that I am suffering. I am in pain. But Allah is Al-Hakim. Allah will give me what is rewarded. Allah will give me what I deserve. And in the end, everything will be fine and all right. Because Allah is Al-Alim and Al-Hakim. So he mentions two names and two attributes that are very powerful and remind us that Allah knows what's happening. It's not that Allah is ghafil, Allah is unaware. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing everything for a divine purpose and wisdom. وَتَوَلَّى عَنْهُمْ He turned away from them. And this is one of the most powerful and moving passages in the entire surah. He turned away from them. And he said, يَا أَسَفَى عَلَى يُوسُفْ Oh, woe to me, still remembering Yusuf. I still have the pain of Yusuf. Oh, woe to me, ya asafa, my sorrow, where is Yusuf? After his son has been taken away, Binyamin, and after the oldest imposes exile upon himself, who does he think of? After 30 years, he still thinks of Yusuf. His two other sons have just been taken away, but look at the status of Yusuf in his heart. After all that has happened, all that he can do is remember with memories his young child Yusuf that was snatched away from him. Ya asafa ala Yusuf. Look at the brothers, what they wanted to do. The brothers wanted to take Yusuf away so that he doesn't think of Yusuf anymore. And all he is doing for the last 30 years is thinking of Yusuf. وَبْيَضَّتْ عَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْحُزْنِ And his eyes had become white because of crying and worry, because of grief. This is the beauty of how the Quran describes the grief of Ya'qub. Allah doesn't say he was sad. Allah doesn't say he cried. Allah said his eyes became white, meaning because of the sorrow of Yusuf's loss, he cried so much that he eventually became blind. وَبْيَضَّتْ عَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْحُزُنِ The grief was so powerful that his eyes went blind. وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ Throughout all of this, he was withholding his emotions. He was taking care of his emotions. And this is the way of the believer. The believer does not go crying and begging and pleading the people for sympathy. What can the sympathy of the people get you? Are they going to give you back what you want? Allah describes him, وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ Meaning he wasn't showing his emotions to them. He was controlling his emotions. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was aware of his emotions. And this is the true man amongst the believers. The true man, the rajul or the rijal, Allah describes him in the Quran. These are not those who go begging the people for their needs and wants. They are those who turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even the least amount of sympathy he did not want from his children. So Allah azza wa jalla describes him that his eyes became white out of sorrow. All he was doing was still thinking about Yusuf. And throughout these 20 or 30 years, throughout this entire time, he was withholding his emotions from mankind. He was controlling his grief so that people were not necessarily sympathizing with him. And such is the way of the believer that they turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We now have reached our first break. We take a short break for these messages and we'll come right back. Stay with us.
لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب.
كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب.
لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب.
كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب.
Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back. We were talking about the grief of Ya'qub alayhi salam, that all of his three sons have been taken away from him, and he is still thinking of the first one that was taken away, and that is Yusuf alayhi salam. And when he turned away from them, وَتَوَلَّى عَنْهُمْ The reason he turned away is that he did not want to expose this grief to them. And he just uttered a word, يَا أَسَفَ عَلَى يُوسُفْ Oh, woe to me, or how sorry it is, I still miss Yusuf. He uttered a word and they overheard it. He turned away from them to hide his grief, but they overheard this particular phrase. And so they respond back, قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ تَفْتَأُ تَذْكُرُ يُوسُفَ حَتَّى تَكُونَ حَرَضًا أَوْ تَكُونَ مِنَ الْهَالِكِينَ So they said, by Allah, you will continue to think of Yusuf until you become harad. Harad means senile. Weak with old age, أو تكون من الهالكين, or until this grief destroys you. So they criticized their father. All you can do is think of Yusuf. All you can do after all this time. And we've just told you that your oldest son is not coming back. We've just told you Binyamin is a slave. And all you can do is remember Yusuf. So they get so irritated, so frustrated. And these are the same brothers who have caused Yusuf to go away. So they have no right to be frustrated. But they become so irritated. They say, all you can do, you will continue. تَفْتَأُ You will continue to remember Yusuf until you become senile, until you become old and crazy, that you have nothing else to do except cry about Yusuf, or until you die because of this grief. And so when they criticized him, he said back, قَالَ إِنَّمَا أَشْكُ بَثِّي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ He said, I am not complaining to you. I am not complaining to anyone else. I only complain of my grief and my sorrow to Allah. I said this for Allah. I didn't say it for you. I don't want your sympathy. I don't want anything from you. وَأَعْلَمُ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ And I know from Allah that which you don't know. Now, here he says that he takes his bath. And bath means the most severe type of distress and grief. So he said that, I complain of this utter grief only to Allah. What does it mean to complain to Allah? To complain to Allah does not mean that you say, Oh Allah, why is this happening to me? Oh Allah, I don't deserve this. No, to complain to Allah means that you seek Allah's mercy. You don't seek the mercy of men. You seek Allah's sympathy. You don't seek the sympathy of men. This is the meaning of complaining to Allah. You say, Oh Allah, you see my situation. Oh Allah, this grieves me greatly. Oh Allah, this hurts me a lot. Oh Allah, make it easy for me. Oh Allah, relieve this distress. This is the meaning of complain. Not to complain that, why is this happening? And I don't deserve this. And why did you do this? This is not the meaning of complain here. We should complain in the first sense. But to complain in the other sense is prohibited. In fact, it is a type of disbelief. To challenge Allah's wisdom is a type of disbelief. So he basically told them, I don't want your sympathy. Rather, I am turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this shows us that at times of grief, at times of distress, when a loved one dies, when you lose your job, when financial income becomes difficult, when any problem is happening, don't turn to men for sympathy. Turn to Allah. Complain to Allah, raise your hands up to Allah, establish a relationship with Allah, and expect Arhamur Rahimin, the most merciful, to show you His mercy. He also tells them, and I know from Allah that which you don't know. What does he know? Well, it is possible that he knew that Yusuf is alive. It is also possible that he knew that Yusuf saw that dream, and so the dream has to be fulfilled. Remember the first dream, and that is the dream of the mother and father and all of the brothers prostrating to Yusuf. So he knows this dream, and he knows that the dream must come true, which means that Yusuf is alive somewhere and he will be reunited with him. So there is some sense of sympathy that yes, I will be reunited. The question is when. So knowing this and realizing this, he then tells them, Ya baniya, O my children, O my sons, idhabu, go out, fatahassasu, search the lands. Go and search far and wide. So tahassus here means search with your utmost diligence. Min Yusuf wa akhihi. For Yusuf and his brother. He is still thinking of Yusuf. His brother is the one missing. But the first name that comes to mind, go and find Yusuf and his brother. Wala tayasu min rawhillah. And do not give up hope of the mercy and the help of Allah. إِنَّهُ لَا يَيْأَسُ مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْكَافِرُونَ That no one can give up hope of Allah's mercy except those who are disbelievers. This is a very, very powerful verse. How many years have gone by since Yusuf is missing? Yet he is still optimistic. And he says, how can you possibly give up hope of Allah's mercy except if you don't believe in Him? If you know who Allah is, you're always optimistic. If you know who Arhamur Rahimin is, if you understand the mercy of Allah, how can you possibly be pessimistic? Pessimism is not a part of Iman. If you're pessimistic about life, if you're always thinking the worst, then realize your Iman is weak. You need to recharge your Iman. He says, nobody can be despaired of the mercy of Allah except the Qawmul Kafirun. And in another verse, Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam says, nobody gives up hope of the mercy of Allah except a people who are zalimun, evildoers. So these two verses put together tells us that giving up hope of Allah's mercy, giving up hope of Allah's blessings is not possible for a Muslim to do. And that is why the Prophet ﷺ said, أكبر الكبائر, the biggest of all major sins, is to worship other than Allah. And to give up hope of the mercy of Allah. And to despair of the help of Allah. To despair of Allah's help, you say, Allah is not going to help me. This, the Prophet ﷺ equated it to shirk. To say, Allah will not forgive me, I'm too sinful. أعوذ بالله, my dear brother or sister, fear Allah. Do you think your sins are so powerful that Allah cannot forgive them? Do you think your evil is more powerful than Allah's good? That you challenge Allah's mercy, you challenge Allah's good, and you say, Allah cannot help me, Allah cannot forgive me. Realize what you are saying. Understand the implications of what you're saying. And fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The mu'min always expects the best from Allah. No matter how great your sins, Allah can forgive them. No matter how desperate your situation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give you what you want. Verily, no one gives up hope of the mercy of Allah except those who do not know who Allah is, except the kafirun. So, they return to Yusuf once again. The third time, they undertake this long and arduous journey. They travel all the way in the desert, walking and plodding along from Philistine all the way to the land of Yusuf in Egypt. And they enter in upon Aziz for the third time. But this time the famine has now gone for many years and they don't have much to give and they are desperate for food and they are only nine now. Three of them are gone. They are only nine. And so they enter in. فَلَمَّا دَخَلُوا عَلَيْهِ قَالُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الْعَزِيزُ. Oh, they entered in upon Yusuf and they said, Oh minister, مَسَّنَا وَأَهْلَنَا الضُّرِّ. Our families are now afflicted with poverty. We don't have enough food for them, nor can we give you enough materials for this quantity of grain. وَجِئْنَا بِبِضَاعَةٍ مُزْجَاتٍ. And we have brought forth a paltry sum to give you. We don't have the normal quantity. Imagine, they don't even have goods to give for food to eat. This is the state of affairs. And look now, Egypt has so much grains that so many years into the famine, still you are getting delegations from other countries and Egypt is able to sell surplus grain to other people. Can you imagine how much money the treasury of Egypt would have made because of Yusuf alayhi salam's wisdom and wise caring? And that is why Yusuf took the position of the finance minister. So now his brothers come again and they say, O minister, we have been afflicted with a great and severe affliction. Not only is it financial, but our father is grief-stricken. He is now struck with grief. وَجِئْنَا بِبِضَاعَةٍ مُزْجَى. And we have come with a measly quantity of goods. They are not very good in quality or in quantity. فَأَوْفِ لَنَا الْكَيْلِ. So give us what we deserve of this quantity. وَتَصَدَّقْ عَلَيْنَا. And give us even more from your charity. So you give us the equivalent of this good and give us even more. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَجَزِي الْمُتَصَدِّقِينَ. Verily, Allah rewards those who are charitable. And this is coming from the very people who have stolen Yusuf. They have kidnapped Yusuf and they say, be charitable to us. After they have stolen the most precious item from their own father, now they have the audacity to beg in front of Yusuf and they say, be charitable to us. Where was their charity when it came to Yusuf alayhi salam? Here now, when Yusuf sees the state of his brothers, begging and their pitiful state. And he knows his father has gone through so much pain and suffering. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows him. Remember, Yusuf alayhi salam cannot do anything except with the permission of Allah. So now Allah allows him to reveal his identity. And so he says, do you remember what you have done to Yusuf and his brother while you were all ignorant? Now nobody knows what they had done to Yusuf except themselves and Yusuf. It was a secret. It was completely hidden. And so when he asked them that question, all of a sudden it clicked. This might be Yusuf. Because the age was right, and perhaps now they could see some semblance, they could see some characteristics that they remember from their brother. So they shout out, قَالُوا أَإِنَّكَ لَأَنْتَ يُوسُفْ. Are you Yusuf? Are you the one? You are Yusuf? قَالَ أَنَا يُوسُفُ وَهَذَا أَخِي. He said, I am Yusuf and this is my brother. قَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا. Allah has been so generous to us. After all that Yusuf has gone through, after all that they have done to him, the first thing that comes out of his mouth when he reveals himself, Allah has been so generous to me. After saving me from all of this, the prison, and saving me from the well, and saving me from slavery, Allah has been so generous to me. إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَتَّقِ وَيَصْبِرْ. Whoever has the patience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah never goes to waste. Allah never leaves the good unrewarded. Everything that you do for good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards it. Meaning, I have become who I am because of my piety to Allah. Because I was good, because I was righteous, this is why I am in the position I am in. So they recognize this and they say, we swear by Allah, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen you and has preferred you over all of us. And we have made a very major mistake. We were sinners in what we have done. And this brings us to the conclusion of today's episode. In our next episode, we will start off and talk about the response of Yusuf alayhi salam and how he was finally reunited with his father. I hope to see you then. Until next time, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب.
كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب.
لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة.
لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب. ما كان حديثا يفترى ولكن تصديق الذي بين يديه وتفصيل كل شيء وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون.